Have you heard of that phrase, football is a game of two halves? Well, it was definitely made for this game today at White Hart Lane. What's going on, everyone? Curtis7 here for the review of Tottenham versus United at White Hart Lane, which finish nil bloody nil. But nil-nil, lads, it was a definitely an entertaining nil-nil draw. Most United Tottenham games are always entertaining, but normally they come with a lot of goals. Unfortunately, today didn't come with any goals. But hey, that's football, right? For me, the story about a game of two halves is definitely about Manchester United and not really about Tottenham. For me, Tottenham were consistent throughout the whole game. They played the same in the second half as they did the first, in my opinion. But anyways, Manchester United, lads, I don't know about Louis van Gaal, but I definitely feel like we dropped 2 points today. Honestly, we should have been we should have had the game wrapped up at halftime. We should have been in that tunnel 3 or 4 nil up, and I'm not even joking. We had a goal disallowed, rightly disallowed. You know, fair play to the linesman. Got to give them praise when they do it. When they finally do have a correct call, and they did. Phil Jones was offside, but nonetheless, lads. Juan Mata hit the post from the free kick. Hugo Lloris won save of the season from that shot from Ashley Young. Oh my God, no matter what we could have done in that first half, lads, nothing was gonna beat Lloris, nothing was gonna get in that goal. And I just wish we came out with that same urgency in the second half. It wasn't meant to be. Tottenham in that first half, lads, didn't have Tottenham, they weren't that threatening. Like, they did have one or two chances. They could have walked away with the game with all 3 points, but they didn't. They had a few chances in the first half, and in the second half, they had a few chances as well. In that first half, lads, for me, it was all about Manchester United. Radamel Falcao played again, started again. I think this is the first time, lads, that Radamel Falcao has played 90 minutes for Manchester United, and it showed yesterday. The lad played twice, well, everyone, I was going to say. Oh, yeah, by the way, we had an unchanged lineup for the first time since 2012. Yes, back when Fergie was there. First time we've gone back-to-back in a game and haven't changed one player. Crazy, right? Since it's been over almost 3 years since it's happened. Anyways, lads, Radamel Falcao, he had this one-on-one chance and the ball just got stuck under his feet and he just couldn't get out in front of him. If the ball was just out in front of him, I know Radamel Falcao would have just put that home, but it wasn't meant to be. Robin Van Persie had so many chances, and that one against Hugo Lloris, he just had to hit it first time. He didn't hit it first time. He brought it down, tried to go around Lloris. It's arguable that, you know, the Robin Van Persie of a couple of years ago would have finished that. It's hard to say, but nonetheless, lads, Hugo Lloris today was man of the match in my opinion. He was just an absolute boss. For me, he got Tottenham the point today. Manchester United did drop 2 points, and Manchester United were very lucky in the end that we walked away with a point, because at the end, Harry Kane held up the ball, brought in Mason, lovely through ball, bit of play from Tottenham, and Mason just skied it over the crossbar, and yeah, it wasn't meant to be. But I tell you what, for the last 5 minutes, I was definitely shitting bricks. I thought we had all these opportunities today, we weren't going to take it, and Tottenham were pressing and pressing. For me, the first half, that first half was fantastic. We just threatened everybody. Everybody played well. Juan Mata was really good. Rooney, Van Persie, Ashley Young for me was fantastic. Valencia was pretty good before he went off at halftime injured. Johnny Evans, I always bring up Johnny Evans. He was okay. I'm not going to say anything bad about him. He was okay, Johnny Evans, but looks like he's injured again. So Chris Smalling came on just after halftime for Johnny Evans. And that was a bit weird. Louis van Gaal made 3 substitutions today. Brought on Raphael, which he was a bit, you know, he's coming back from injury. Luke Shaw came back, and Chris Smalling, three substitutions. 3 defenders all coming on. Which is a bit sad because I really wanted to see Wilson. Wilson could have been the type of player to get behind Tottenham's defence. That Tottenham were playing so high up the pitch. They were playing such a high line. And someone with speed. Today we could have done with Adnan or today we could have done with Angel Di Maria. But I guess anyone could do it. Angel Di Maria, couldn't they? But someone with a bit of speed to get past this defence. Juan Mata was playing lovely overhead through balls past the line. And I tell you what, we just lacked that speed up front. It really cost us today. That's why Ashley Young, for me, had a great game. He was one of our avenues to goal. Well, on the wing anyways, you can see he was causing Kyrkaeus all the problems in the world. Played a great game today. But like I said, lads, today, for me, feels definitely like 2 points dropped. Definitely. Juan Mata had that brilliant chance in the second half. I think it was Rafael who crossed it along the floor to him, and he just put it in row Z. I think it ended up at the Emirates Stadium. That's how high he kicked this ball. But anyways, lads, it wasn't meant to be. 0-0. Again, we're still undefeated in 8 or 9 games, something like that. Correct me if I'm wrong. Let me know in the comments down below. I guess if you had offered me a point at White Hart Lane before the game, I probably would have taken it. Keep this run going. I think that, correct me if I'm wrong, I think there's a little bit of a break now. I think there's back to a week, a bit of a break, 7 days time. I think our next game is in the FA Cup against Yeovil, I think. Correct me if I'm wrong. But lads, apparently Angel Di Maria will be back. Adnan Yanezay, I'm not too sure what's happening with Adnan at the minute. So all things are looking positive, and at the end of the day, because everybody else dropped points, I don't think it was that, catastrophic. City dropped points, Chelsea dropped points. The only team that, who were in competition with that didn't drop points was Arsenal, who got a victory. So it's not the end of the world, but definitely feels like 2 point drop, 2 points dropped for me. But anyways, lads, that's my review of the Tottenham game. Give me your opinions, and man of the match for me, goes to Hugo Lloris, man of the match by far. Anyways, lads, give me your man of the match in the comments down below. If you like this review, please hit that thumbs up for more. Anyways, I'm your boy, Curtis7. If you want to follow me on social media accounts, make sure you click that link in the description. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all those things you can find down there. Anyways, lads, I'm your boy, Curtis7. Take care and peace.